Okay, this is part two. I had to change the batteries. Part one was only about 2 minutes long, if that. But there's my marigolds I had bought from China Mart and had six containers. They all died except for one. My wife planted them out here. There was two of them that weren't even opened yet, but they've come out. We've planted marigolds all around the edges of the garden. You can see the grass is up here. Because it's like it's mounds of soil, dirt, whatever you want to call it, up to the edges of the garden. And I'd rather use a weed trimmer, which you buy those, and then the next thing you know, you can't get a refill rack for it. And anyway, so we got marigolds and all types of other flowers playing around here, but all I see is grass, those marigolds and those flowers right there. It's a type of flower. But we planted some more okra, like one there, two, three, four, five, or six. I think I planted six more here. Plus we have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. But one back there looks like it's dying from the wind out here now. This is all from the wind. Just like those right there. The wind was so bad. I tell you people, the wind's been bad and very nasty. Well, it broke that one. It actually blew it over and broke it. My wife came out here after it rained one time and it was bent over. Corn, I had three rows of 12, which is 36, and I planted six more, made it 42 out here. So, I started getting quicker. Instead of doing it every 3 weeks, I went 2 weeks after those, I planted these, and now these 12, I got, I don't know if that's one down or not, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 out of 12 are growing. It's been about 2 weeks now, 2.5 weeks maybe. And then I just planted these maybe about 4 days ago. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Give me 42 ears out here. I mean, 42 stalks out here. 2 ears approximately per stalk. Thinned out the grass between the garlic here. We planted it in the 1st of November last year. So I think it's around the end of, I don't know if it's for sure 10 months, but from the 1st of November is when those came up. And then we planted these here. It's on a previous video. There's six here, or eight here and six there, 14. I planted another pumpkin yesterday right down there. Now, there should be three. If three come up, I'm killing off two and just keeping one because we got a pumpkin that's here from last year. This is the zucchini I was talking about before the battery started flashing bad and that shut off. See, there's one down there right there. I figure about 2 weeks, 3 weeks from now, we're going to have that one. We got one more down there with a flower, and then there's other zucchini right there and the flower blooms. The Black Beauty, which is the traditional green zucchini, they're fuzzy looking right there. You can see the flower bud. Let's see right in the camera. I can't see. Flower bud on the end of it. But it's a fuzzy looking cylinder instead of the green zucchini like those yellow ones down inside there. See, the yellow ones, they come out as the actual vegetable, fruit, whatever you want to call it. We planted, there's two cucumber right there, two right there, one there, and I put one down here. So it'd be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, six cucumber. We were only going to plant three or four, and now we got six. So I'll tell you, one of the best things you could ever do, juice them. I swear to you, take just a one or two raw zucchini or one or two raw cucumbers and just juice them, and they taste so good and they're so healthy for you. You get all the nutrients and vitamins, and it's liquid, so it gets into your system faster. Watermelon here, I have planted several times, one or two watermelons. I'm wondering if the seeds, because they were from the watermelons last year, and we saved some, but I don't know if we let them go far enough to be harvested. We got them when there were so many because we were overwhelmed out here with cucumber and zucchini. If you look on videos from last year, this was just totally covered all the way across here from the cucumber zucchini. And I had beans over here, purple hull and I forget the others now. Purple hull peas, green beans and another one. But this year it's going to be watermelon and cantaloupe over here. These are coming up right here. That one there, that one, that one there. And then these are, I forget the bean. I want to say scarlet, but I don't think it's a scarlet bean. If anybody knows, feel free to comment about this. But they were the bean that was almost the size of a quarter, purple and white marble looking. So I got one up there, two down here. Then I have the same size bean, only white, over in the next row over. I got one there and one there. I thought I had two over there, but I guess not. So I gotta watch, I don't step on these plants now. I just replanted another okra. There should be three of them down there. See, they all should come up about the same size as this right there. That's about 4 inches above the ground. There's an okra. There's an okra right there. And I'm just gonna stop right here because there's one right there. They're all about 4 to 5 inches above the ground. And then from the back of the garden, I'm looking south. You can see the watermelon over there and cantaloupe, and then we got one, two beans, well actually technically four or five beans growing. Then there's a row here where nothing's coming up yet. Then there's another one here. See, I have on previous videos, and I get to the point, I get so disgusted, I have these different types of beans I plant out here. So there's about 6 to 10 varieties of beans out here. But this one here I've got set up here. And I have, there's two I believe in this space right here. Yep, two down there coming up. And I think this is two. Yep, two down there too. So I got these going here, and I get some string that I have going from that. Everything's made from scratch too, so it's not bought from the store. And go, oh look, I just set this up. No, I did all this, my wife and I both. But it's 50 by 3 foot, 16 gauge wire fencing. And I rolled the thing out and I cut it in half. As you can see, the bottoms of this right here is sharp right there, like that. So one end was like the top of this one here, smooth, and the other one's right there. And most of them I bent them up, but then I just said, heck with it, I ain't gonna reach down there anyway. So 50 feet became 100 feet at 18 inches instead of 3 feet. So now I need to get the ones that I'm growing. I might use these too, because I have 1, 2, 3, 4 bean plants right now. With not, and that one right there has just got that little fencing. It's about 4 feet right there. I'm going to use this. And if I can get another row, I'm going to do the same thing. Cut it in half. And then cut it about, I think I'm going to do it in like 5 foot sections. And just separate them by about a foot when I need to keep, so I don't have to use it all up. Like how I did there with the string to cross it over. So the bean will go right, the bean will continuously crawl over. More okra, there's another okra right there. You can see them. And these are where future tomatoes are gonna go here. What these stakes are. Okra in the back. Some of these don't look great, but they're doing okay. They were a lot worse than this, actually. They were curled up from this wind, as you can see from my makeshift wind socks. This one's been blown over several times. You know, that cinder, little piece of a cinder block of that was knocked over 3 or 4 times at least. And come out here and pick it up. But then I got this tomato right here. It's got a tomato plant rather. It has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tomatoes I can see on here. There's your biggest ones. 1, 2, 3. Then you have 4, 5. Yeah, I believe there was a 6-1, but I can't really see it right now. So, and see how these are curled? This is a direct cause because of the wind. See how these leaves are curled? They're not dead. This is protecting the plant, how it's protected. Use Epsom salt and sugar in with water. 2 tablespoons of Epsom salt, 1 tablespoon of sugar to a gallon of water. And now we have coffee grounds on the top here to keep the hornworms from getting on the plant. You put that down in there for the roots to get that nutrition from those. So, and that's why I think they're all coming back. They're green, better. These are real healthy. It's the 27th day of May, by the way. It's Saturday. Memorial Day weekend, as a matter of fact. What a joke. Anybody says happy Memorial Day should get a knock in the mouth with a... Anyway, I'm just keeping my opinions myself. So anyway, see, all these tomatoes died off. From the wind out here was so bad. That one there, barely hanging on maybe. Probably not, it's probably gonna die. That one there is green. Green doesn't always mean the best, but it's better than that. That one there. So, you know, we have locations for them. The sunflower fence. See, now, if it was like this at the beginning of April, this would have been great. But, you know, I started this early. I thought enough. But we put the garden out right away, too. We got everything out about 3 weeks, almost a month earlier than you normally would. And paying the consequences, paying the price as a consequence. Because the wind out here has just been amazing. My peanuts, only one of these are growing, and I don't understand that. I got 1, 2, 3, 4 locations where I have peanuts down in here. And that's the only one that I see coming up, peanut. So. And here's from last year, the cucumber, because we thought we had zucchini in this first garden here. It turned out to be cucumber. And the seed must have fell down in there, and this looks good. The flower's opening up, but like I say, we have hummingbirds out here. We got hummingbird feeders around the house. There's probably about 20 of them out here now. And butterflies and bees are the main thing we need out here to help pollinate all this stuff. Yeah, you see now, that's what the wind, this is what the rain and the wind has done out here. Right there. It knocked that over. It flooded out here like it has several times. And then the wind, and like I say, there's your wind. So it's not like a little breeze here and there and that's it. It's usually constant wind and then strong gusts. And here's part of last year we had the torch sunflowers along here, which attracts the large winged butterflies, hummingbirds, and honey bees. And the seeds just fell here, and I'm just letting them grow up here in this little corner here. We'll have them. Plus, I got them mixed in with these around here. Although all I'm seeing is yellow sunflowers on the back there is, might be. I don't know if that's even got the torch sunflowers. Those might be just the yellowhead sunflowers, the traditional type sunflowers. But I got them around here because they'll attract the big winged butterflies primarily, and honeybees and hummingbirds. So, you know, this is another heirloom flower of some sort right here. Oh, I can't think of the name of it. It looks like a daisy. If you look it up, it's a herb. You have to look it up. It's an herb. I just realized that because that's what I put right here, right where this is, like a little row. I just put sunflowers here, and then I put row right here and on the other side. And these are the only ones that have come up so far, plus the sunflowers. See right here, but then again, we've walked around here. The dogs have been out here, and should be like a row right here, too. So anyway, that's a brief overview of the garden. So this is part two. This is about 7-8 minutes long at least, and the other one was only about a minute to 2 minutes long. So, I suggest some people grow you a tomato plant, maybe a pepper plant at the very least, maybe okra. Excellent vitamins in okra, man. I'm telling you, when they're on the stalk, when they're on the plant, just peel them off and start eating them. They're great. My dogs love them. I love them. So, do what you can. Government's not going to do it for you. Trust me. And if they tell you they are, they're lying. Do what you can with what you got, okay? Stay safe.